These trips, they couldn't have been like all during the summer, right? So school must have been a
No.
lot different for you.
Yeah,
Right.
so when you are a working kid, if you're under the age of 18, you're by law, legally, you have to have a teacher on set with you. You have to do at least 3 hours of schooling a day or you're not allowed to work. So when you're on tour, you have like, depending on how many kids there are, you may have one teacher, you may have two, you may have three, you may have four, touring with you at all times. So if it was a weekday, we would have school at the theater before our show, and then we would go back to our hotel or go into town and get dinner, do our show, do it all again the next day.
Wow.
Yeah, and if so, there were a lot of kids in Matilda, and not that many in Lima's. Obviously, there were like four, but so many kids in Matilda. So obviously, there were understudies. So if you weren't like actually on stage one night, you would be backstage and you would be doing school and on standby in case something happened.
Okay, wait.
Wow.
So fast forward to like 2020 now when you're 15 again, in honor to have a 15-year-old
Thank you.
on the show. So do you go to like a special school for like performing
Yeah,
arts or
I
like
go to a really.
celebrities?
Yeah. So I go to a special school where I live, and it's a school that basically just is a school for people with careers, kids with careers. So
Yeah,
there's
yeah.
actors, singers, dancers, athletes, musicians, entrepreneurs, anything you can really think of.
Okay.
People there,
Let me ask this. So like how are the teachers there? Are they understanding? Are
they
they
are
all like
so
pushing? Yeah.
fantastic.
'Cause
They
it's
are.
Wait,
Like
all
how
right,
many
if I
like
could just
hours
if
does Oh,
yeah.
you go.
Yeah, how many hours of school, man?
It's a
Yeah.
normal school day. I
Oh,
have
really?
school from 8:50 to 2:30.
Because,
Eight
okay,
oh wait,
so
that's shorter
basically,
than 8:50 to
yeah.
2:30.
Yeah.
Well, that's
Ours
because
starts
that's
at,
a
no, it's not. Or it's like an hour shorter. But
I
like
have
one of
for
the
spring free, so
things that we're gonna
yeah.
talk about like a lot on this show is school, because I know that's something like I'm so passionate about. I know Dennis Noah has become like very passionate about it. And like I have a ton of opinions that we can get into like another time about like how I feel like in school the teachers need to and the people that make the curriculum need to do a better job of bringing out that creative side in kids,
And not, yeah.
and not just stressing these standardized tests that are that we have every week. I mean,
Do you
if
get the
I could,
standardized tests every week?
oh, in some of my
Yeah.
classes, and especially in a year like this year,
There's
like
so
I
many
wanted to
tests.
share,
I used to have
like
a math test every
I
single
just.
week. It's terrible.
No, we have a math test every week, and I wanted like I was thinking. So I was doing a lesson, like so now COVID, we have online lessons with videos, and like
Oh,
you
they're
take your
so bad.
notes.
They're
At
so
the
bad.
beginning of one of these videos, the teacher literally goes, "So, today we're gonna teach you this lesson about your test tomorrow, and you may not become a master at it today, but after a couple of days of practice, you will." And I'm like, "What the fuck? What is this? Like we have a test, right? A test is about mastery, but the goal is to get 100% on the test. And personally, and I know many other students get very discouraged by getting something that's not in 100 and really strive and work very hard to get a grade that's over in 100, right?
Yo, literally,
So
what?
if I'm not able to ma if you're telling me I'm not able to master that skill, how am I supposed to be successful? So like I just wanted like to touch on that briefly, and we're gonna get into that so much on this podcast, because as you could see, that like really brought the fire out of me. I'm very passionate about that subject. But what are like some of the things that your teachers do? Do they help you out with your career? And do they understand that like at the end of the day, the world is changing, and not everyone's going to be a scientist when they grow up. Not everyone's going to be a mathematician. There's certain subjects that are important, but not everyone's going to do what they do.
Yeah, definitely. My teachers at my school are so forgiving and so kind, and they really are just there to help you. Like, they're really just there to, like, make you succeed and to help you succeed. If I'm struggling in a subject, my teachers will reach out to me first and they'll say, "Hey, let's set up a meeting."
That's awesome. I mean,
God,
yeah,
I have one
Ari,
teacher
go
like
ahead.
that. I have one teacher
Every
like that.
single teacher. And they all
No.
will make comments on my work. when I hand it in, they'll say, okay, do it again. Now do it like this. I'll hand it back in. I'll get 100.
And
my
you know,
teacher got
definitely...
so frustrated when I asked her a question like a week or two ago. She's like, well, shouldn't you know that? I just moved into this class. So I was like, no.
No,
she was
I
like yelling at me, and I was new to the class, so I was like, are you serious? And I wanted to say something, but you know, you can't really talk back to a teacher,
especially this year. Like, we're at school every other day, and most of the time we're at virtual school because, you know, we got these irresponsible kids that don't wear a freaking mask. That's a whole nother subject.
Wear a mask.
Whatever,
you guys are gonna take anything
Yo, facts.
Away from this. Wear your stupid mask so we can all get back to our silly
yeah.
little lives.
Jesus,
yeah.
I mean. And it's good like, God. I feel there's definitely some teachers that understand, right? I have a bunch of teachers that maybe don't put as much effort as they could
mm-hmm,
in because,
for sure.
you know, they have children. They have children that they have to deal with. And I completely understand. So if that takes a gap out of your life away from teaching, then don't give us as many, you know, quizzes and tests. And there's some teachers that do that, some teachers that don't. And I just feel like, you know, nowadays with COVID, it's tough. It's tricky.
But if you are a teacher out there, credit to you. But
that's a lot
take
of
our
work.
Advice.
Hey, next episode we are dedicating a whole episode on stories, advice, and you know it's not to discourage you or anything, but we're just here
to
you know
to voice
make
our
it better.
Opinions.
Yeah, and shout out Prince EA. That's like one of the guys
oh, yeah.
I first saw.
Oh, that random dude.
His content
he's
is
awesome.
His
yeah,
content's
he's
awesome.
Sick. He's sick, yeah.
Yeah.
No, but my teachers at my school really just want to help me succeed. My classes are super small, and my history class, which is my favorite class ever. I'm in history too. It's so fantastic. It's me and one other kid and my teacher.
Wait.
That's my entire class.
Are you kidding
really?
Me?
I'm so serious, and it is my favorite class, and I'm so engaged. And my teacher really has such creative projects for us. All my teachers have such creative projects, and they're all so sweet and so kind, and I've never been happier with my teachers, ever.
So just to compare and contrast, like you said that your teachers are so creative with their assignments. So give me an example, and then I'll give you an example of me and Dennis go to the same school, not Ari, but like
an example
of what our work, yeah, what our work is like so we can see. I'm very curious.
So, maybe give me a second, but maybe they're not necessarily creative. It's nothing special. It's just that they are engaging and they care about
engaging.
What they're doing.
Okay. Yeah.
Like,
no. And I think there's some like subjects that do that. Like, for example, like I think, you know, Spanish, you know, it has its ups and downs because
it's so funny.
Because of the language barrier between teachers and students. And, you know, sometimes those teachers aren't. I'm not going to get into that, but
not very fond
I think,
of your Spanish teacher.
Okay.
just to voice it.
At my old school, my old Spanish teacher was, I'm not going to sugarcoat it, abusive.
Really?
Yep.
Abusive?
We'll
like,
get into that.
Physically?
Like you would get hit?
Not physically, but there's
mentally.
Recordings. There are recordings of people
like yelling?
Going at me.
Oh.
I have a recording from my math lab class of this guy. He had like I was in math lab in like sixth or seventh grade, I remember. And this guy, like, he had a stroke a couple years earlier, so he wasn't there fully. So he was like screaming at the kids all the time, and like I don't go to the nicest schools where I live. I don't go to like private schools or anything. So the kids aren't always great.
That's how it was.
And you had this old dude who had a stroke and wasn't fully there in his head, teaching like these not nice kids. So it was it was difficult.
I don't know how some of these people get like hired. I don't get it.
We have to save this for the episode. We have to save this for the episode.
Yeah, I was gonna tell a story that I told Ari and Dennis on Xbox, but I'll save it for next week. About speaking about being like abusive with words, I have a good story for next week.
Oh man.